Duel Monsters has gotten very popular lately. The game evolved quite a bit, hasn't it? Oh well. It's my job as a duelist to duel, isn't that right? After all, with all the great duelists out there, maybe I should make a name for myself. Isn't that right, Barbaros? You know, you always had my back. Through thick and thin. Who knows? Maybe I'll become the next King of Games. Something feels off. I have no idea what that presence is, but might as well go check it out. It could be nothing, but I don't know.
Hello, stranger. Might I ask for your name?
My name is Thomas, and who are you?
My name is Cyril Woolsup, and I'm here to search for the King's cards. Might I ask, do you have anybody in each chance?
Look, dude, I have no idea what the King's cards are, and I don't think I have any.
Don't worry, I know who you are, little Thomas.
Okay, so if you know about me, and I'm not sure how you got into my building, that leaves one question. What exactly are you, Woes?
Oh, what am I? Well, I already gave you my name, but here's my duel disc. I would like a duel with you, if you don't mind me asking.
Okay, I can see your duel disc and depth, but why would you want to duel me? I mean, I'm not like any other duelists out there. I'm pretty ordinary in skill and in cards. I mean, this just doesn't make any sense.
Why would I want to duel you? Oh well, you know how it is. When duelists see each other, a battle is always an outcome. So, get your deck and duel disc ready.
Look, I don't mind us dueling, but as you see, I have no duel disc. So how are we gonna do this with just my deck?
What? You don't have a duel disc? Well, I guess I'll give you one. Here you go.
Oh, thanks for the loaner.
If you win, you can keep it. Now, shall we begin the game?
When I'm definitely keeping this style of thing. Now let's see, deck goes in here. Goes there. Loop here. Sorry, it's the first time wearing one of these. So I have no experience in putting them on. But, yeah. Okay, Shiro. I'm ready to go.
Let's do. I'll make the first move. Let's see how good you start off. With this Penton. The Dark Clown. I know it's a weak monster, but this is just the dawn of the duel after all. And I want to see how well you can be stacked up against him. Then I'll set one card face down It's your turn, little Thomas. Let me see what you got.
Ooh, nice setup, Shiro. I guess you're trying to test me or something. Well, let's see what I got, shall we? I draw. Not a bad hand. Well, first off, by discarding one card from my hand, I'll special summon the Tricky. But he won't stay on for long, because then I'll activate the spell card. 5-star Twilight. Now, this card can only be activated if I have a level 5 monster on my field, which the Tricky obviously is. Now, by releasing my Tricky, I can special summon up to 5 Kariba Blokes from my deck. But they won't stay on the field for long. Now, by releasing them, I can special summon a much more bigger fuzzball from my deck. You may seem familiar, since the King game was only used him twice in his dueling career. Now, by releasing all 5 Kariba brothers, I can special summon from my deck. Curry Babylon! And you know what Curry Babylon does. While he's on the field, he gains 300 attack points for each of the Kariba brothers that are in my graveyard. And since I have 5 different Kariba brothers, that means his attack power becomes 3,000. Then, I summon my Beast King Barbaros in attack mode. Like, you may be thinking, Barbaros is a elite monster. I cannot summon him normally. Well, you'd be wrong. See, I can normal summon Barbaros, but his original attack points become 1900, which is well worth the cost in my opinion. I'll set one card face down. Then I'll have my Babylon attack your pet in the dark cloud. Go! Fuzzball Horn!
Well now, little Thomas, you did pretty good there. But you know the effect of Pent in the Dark Cloud. When he's destroyed in battle, I start summoning another Pent in defense mode.
Of course Pent would special summon a copy of itself. How could I forget? Oh well, I'll use my Barbaros to attack your second Pent.
Now then, let's see, that was a great damage. Let's do attack with Barbaros. I'll use Pent to fight again. Now it goes to the graveyard. I pull out one more Pent from my deck in defense mode.
Well, there's nothing much else to do from there, so I'll end my turn. Your move, Shiro.
My turn. I draw. I am so close to taking my hit. I'll set this monster face down the first one. To follow up. One card face down. And that ends my turn. Show me what you can do with that nice little offensive you have, little Thomas.
So what? You think a few little defensive monsters are going to stop me? I draw. I'll put a spell card, War of Darkness. With this, I banish one dark monster. And drop 2 cards. So I'll banish 2 new puppies. Next, I'll have my Curry Babylon. I'll attack that mystery stead monster of yours since I know you'll summon
craftsman something with that little clown of yours.
Well, little Thomas, since you attacked my mystery scent monster, we might as well reveal a kind what it is. You attacked my lamp, and using its effect during the damage step, when it gets flipped face up, I can redirect your attack target, and I'll choose your little weakened Barbaros over there.
No! Barbaros!
Yeah.
You pay for that little sneaky tactic. I'll set one card face down and end my turn.
Now it's my turn. I draw. And due to my lamp's special ability, I'll first summon the genie. Come forth, legend! And I'm not through just yet. I'll release my legend and my lap to summon the most fearsome monster. A monster that is one of a kind, you might say. A gold rare, blue-eyed, white dragon!
What? You have a gold rare, blue-eyed, white dragon? But those cards are hella expensive, man! I mean, I know kind of, but made it. Well, actually, no, that was a false rumor. The real reason why there's more than one blue eyes is because Pegasus wanted to piss off Kaivas, and that's why he made those copies, but there are only four gold blue eyes!
Shit! And indeed, this blue eyes, there's only four kinds. But don't worry, I don't have all of them in my deck. I only just need one for my deck.
Well, anyways, nice try, but you can't destroy my custom with your blue eyes. I mean, they'll both get killed.
I know your monster and mine have the same attack point, but by using my Buster of Destruction card, I can get rid of your Babylon and destroy it.
No! My cost on! What am I going to do now?
But by doing so, my blue-eyes white dragon cannot attack. But so, little Thomas, I still have my Painted the Dark Cloud. Now I switch into attack mode. Painted attack! Bloodlust slash!
I'm down to only a few points left. Come on. Give me something. I draw. Got nothing. Looks like I'm gonna have to rely on a monster reborn. With this, I'll bring back a monster from my graveyard. The graveyard has really nothing I can use. So the monster I'll be going for is my newly full-powered Beast King Barbarox! But that's not all. I'll also play my Jar of Avarice. With this, I can return any five cards from my graveyard. And the cards I will be returning are the Tricky, Five-Star Twilight, Monster Reborn, my Raikeki bottle, and finally, my Allure of Darkness. I'll return these five to my deck, shuffle, and draw one card. Set this card face down. It's your move, Shiro.
So, you decide to bring back your Barbaros. What a nice little play. Really is. I draw. I'll activate my first stream of destruction.
this destroys your Barbaros, but I can't attack with Alua.
Not again! Not my Barbaros!
So, I'll switch this little guy into attack mode. And I'll attack with my cloud! Bloodlust Slash!
I got nothing. I'm doomed!
Now it's my turn. You have nothing left on your field to defend yourself. I draw. I like to paint my face down so my face down card. The Zangzin replica. And I'll target that face down card of yours. I only have one in my deck, so I can negate or lock down one of your face down spells and traps. I was meaning to get the actual Zangzin from you, but that's neither here nor there. This duel is over. Blue Eyes White Dragon, direct attack, white lightning!
I figured you had something that powerful to wipe out the rest of my life when Disney kept this puppy in reserve. Magic Cylinder, this duel is over. Now your monster will attack you!
What? Magic Cylinder? Ah! Very impressive, little Thomas. You have beaten me. I figure you had some skill up your sleeve. And since you won, you get to keep this little doof this as a souvenir.
Thank for the duel this. I mean, this thing is hella sweet, but why did you came to me and challenge me to a duel?
Why I came to you, you may ask? Well, I just wanted to see if you're good or not, that's all.
Okay, I see how that checked out. You want to see my duelist skill, but why earlier on did you refer to we? Are you working with some evil organization, some evil group or something?
Well, I'm a part of a little group of duel monsters players. You could say a guild. We look for new and upcoming duelists to see how good they are. We're not a typically bad organization. We just like to see who can enter the pro leagues. To see who's up to snuff. That type of deal, you know.
Oh. So you're part of a group of duelists, huh? Okay, that checked out. Then why the hell does your voice sound so menacing like an antagonist in this from a live-action anime adaptation? That sounds sus.
And why I sound menacing, you may ask? Oh, that's just a huge misunderstanding, little Thomas. See, I have a sore throat. That's why my voice sounds like, I don't know, some weirdo. Some killer. I mean, seriously. Who in the right minds would sound like a serial killer on purpose? I hope we can be good friends, little Thomas. Anyways, keep your eyes and ears out for any news of the gold cards.
Oh, okay, that makes sense, but you said something about gold cards. Do you, like, that seems a bit suspicious as well. What exactly are the gold cards?
Oh, that's more information for another time, but due to the internet, I think you know how you can look this up. See you, little Thomas, and be wary of the gold cards.
Since Shiro's gone, then I guess I can go back to normal, but the gold cards. That sounds interesting. I'm gonna have to look into that.
Okay, time to find out what these King's cards really are. You referred to them as gold cards as well? These King cards and gold cards are the same thing. Gold by different names, by different regions of the world, but they seem to be very rare, very valuable. This article says these cards were owned by King Minus. That's ridiculous. There's more detail here. The gold cards have some essence of the Shao game within them. Let's see here. What does King Minus have to do with duel monsters? I thought that that was just like a fictional story. It seems here that King Minus was an advanced user of the Shadow Games, one of the relatively modern and much more powerful wielders of the cause. And his bow is incredibly intense, so on the level of King Atem. Let's see here. Scholars indicate that King Minus always hold a penalty game of the Minus Touch. He imbued his cause with the magic that cursed him when he touched everything to gold. So that must be King's Minus' form of a penalty game. Let's see here. Other rumors may suspect that the gold cards or King's cards have the ability to cast a penalty game, the equivalent to the Minus Touch, of the loser of the duel. No wonder why these gold cards are pretty rare and pretty scarce. If anyone gets their hands on them, they could rich and probably kill a lot of people. Well, but Shiro has a gold card himself. Could that golden blue eyes be a gold card?
What to do? Gold cards seem pretty deadly if gotten into the wrong hands, but I ain't no hero. I'm just a random duelist. Although, given the frequency of people using duel monsters for their own game around the world, there could be a spike in the Shadow Games. I've been hearing rumors that the Shadow Games are making the comeback, but I thought only those with magic or millennium items could wield such power. This is going to do a lot of research. Good thing I'm a bit adept at sorcery. Right, what to do? I might as well research those who've dealt with these Shadow Games.
I see. Looks like some of the famous duelists have dealt with the Shadow Games. One of them was Prescott Comore over in Wisconsin. Their one is currently known as Tom Elkman. His region is unidentified. And what else? There's been recent activities with Shadow Games with other duelists as far as the internet is knowing, but well, I guess I had to dust that book off. Well, I'm the only one who knows the real truth of the Shadow Games. But that information will be kept secret. Well, if there is a resurgence in the Shadow Games, I guess sooner or later I might encounter a Shadow Duelist. But they may know how to use the Shadow Game, but their levels are just basic compared to my knowledge. In due time, we might risk our souls. Isn't that right, Barbaros?
Well, let's see what the future holds. Couple gold cards. I'm gonna make sure I'll get a few or lock them up. Yeah, using them could sound dangerous if I don't know how to tame them, but that's maybe worth the risk. I could become a target if some weird evil organization tried to hunt me down for my collection of gold cards. But even so, might as well try to find them and put them away. This is going to be quite an interesting adventure. Well then, let the hunt begin.